dancing in the dark in the pale moonlight. Done my hair up real big, beauty queen style. High heels off, I'm feeling alive. Oh my God, I feel it in the air. Telephone wires above, all sizzling like a snare. Honey, I'm on fire, I feel it everywhere. Nothing scares me and
I have a brain freeze. Brain freeze! Brain freeze! Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a tutorial on this look that I have going on right here. I actually wore this look yesterday because I went to a Ukrainian New Year's Eve party and it was so much fun. And I actually wore this look to that party. And I did change it up a little bit, but overall it's pretty much the same look. But I just changed up. So yes, I am wearing false lashes for the first time on camera. I'm so excited. I've never really done this on camera before, but I've been practicing for several days, weeks, months. You get the picture. But yeah, I have really been trying to do those. So I have false lashes on right now and I'm really proud of myself for putting them on. So pathetic, I know, but be proud for me, please. Thank you so much for watching. I will leave you guys to enjoy this video, and this video will start in about 3, 2, and then 1. Let's go! So for foundation, I used a mixture. I used the Sephora Fond de Teint Perfection 10 Hour Wear Foundation. I think I said that wrong. But this is basically the foundation that I'm going to be using, and I'm going to be mixing this with the L'Oreal Paris Visible Lift Blur Concealer. This is a great concealer. I love this so much. I'm going to be using a flat brush. This is a great way to get more coverage out of your foundation because a flat brush is basically like a paintbrush. So you're basically essentially painting the foundation on. I'm putting the remaining foundation on my neck, because that will sort of even everything out. And I'm just going to blend it in with the Real Techniques buffing brush. This is my favorite brush by far for blending in foundation, concealer, pretty much everything on my face. This brush is so universal for me. I love it. So for extra coverage, I'm adding some Maybelline concealer. This is the Fit Me concealer, my favorite concealer by far, I think. And I'm just putting this in a triangle underneath my eye, on my chin, on my nose, and on any blemishes that might still need some covering up. So one of my goals with my makeup last night was to not only make sure it looked beautiful, but also ensure that it stayed for the entire night, that my makeup didn't melt off, because I was sweating a lot because I was dancing, I was performing, I was dancing afterwards. So I had to make sure my makeup would stay on. So a great way to do this is to bake. So I'm using the Coty Airspun Powder and this contour brush by Real Techniques. This is my favorite brush for baking. And I'm just using this to basically bake my under eye area, and of course also the area by my jawline as well. Today I'm applying a thinner layer of powder than what I had last night, because last night was obviously more high maintenance, and today I just want to go thinner layers. So I'm just going to brush off the excess. I did wait last night for this to set, because that really makes sure your makeup doesn't budge, but I honestly just want to go a little bit less powdery today, because I want to make this a more daytime appropriate look, since this is the middle of the day and I'm planning to go to the store. So like, I don't have to be as high maintenance, I don't have to worry about sweating so much, so I'm going to not use as much powder. I'm going to save myself some trouble and get rid of the baking real quickly. So yeah, I want to go into contouring now, so I'm going to be using the Anastasia Beverly Hills contour palette with this Benefit Cosmetics little brush. This came in a palette or a blush, I can't remember, but this is a great brush. I love it. It reminds me a lot of the more high-end, more expensive contour brushes, and I like this because it was very inexpensive in my opinion, and it works so well because it's the perfect density to give me like a structured contour, but not to make it so it's like this harsh jagged line. So I really like this. So I'm just going to be using this to contour my cheekbones. So one of the reasons I like this brush so much is because I can easily use it to blend out everything on my face, even powder. So I'm just going to use this to blend everything out. I do want a structured contour, which is why I made such a very precise contour. So a great way to soften this up but to still maintain that structuredness is to just go back and forth with this brush, and this really blends everything out. So to prime my eyes, I'm using the NYX Incredible Waterproof Concealer. I need to cover up some eyelash glue on my lids because eyelash glue is such a pain to remove, and I was wearing lashes last night, so there's eyelash glue on my lashes. For transition color, I'm going to be going into my Kat Von D Shade and Light Eye Palette. I'm going to be using this shade right here for transition. You do not have to use this palette. This is optional. I just like this palette because I have it, and this shade happens to be a perfect transition color for me. Any kind of light brown matte shade will do for a transition. You do not have to use this palette. You do not have to go out and buy this palette just for this look. I do recommend this palette because this palette is really great, but you do not need to buy this palette just for this one eyeshadow. For some reason, the transition color with this brush worked out a lot better yesterday than it is doing today. So to fix this unblended mess that I have going on here, I'm just going to be taking a slightly lighter color using my Morphe palette. And I'm just going to be taking this color right here, which is just a lighter version of that color that we were using earlier. And I'm just going to be taking a Real Techniques brush, and I'm just going to be lightly blending this in. A great trick that I've learned is if you have ever had an unblended eyeshadow, a great way to blend it out is to take a shade, a few shades lighter than the shade that you're working with, and just to use that shade to blend this all in. So now for the fun part, we're going to be going in with ColourPop eyeshadows. They're gorgeous. I love them. I use them all the time. I'm going to be using Lala first. I'm applying this pretty lightly all over the inner part of my eye and extending it out to the middle part of my eye. This will really warm my eye up and give it a kind of glowy pinky look. I really love this eyeshadow. You can easily build it up, but for this look we're going to be going a little bit on the neutral side and then build up later. We're going to be going in with this color next. This is the Central Perk shade. This is from their fall collection. It's so beautiful. It's this very dark maroon color, and to apply it we're going to be using a flat synthetic brush. So I applied Central Perk to my outer corner in a V shape, and I blended this out using the EcoTools brush that I have right here. We're just going to make sure that this is a pretty seamless blended out eye look, because I really want this to be very blended, of course. I'm going in with a little bit more of the Shade and Light Eye Palette from Kat Von D. I'm going to be using this Cranberry shade right here, and I'm just going to apply this to my crease just to make sure that color is very blended to the Central Perk eyeshadow, because I'm having a little bit of trouble blending that shade in because I feel like I waited too long and now it's a harsh line, which is too harsh for me. So I'm just going to blend this out with the help of this powder eyeshadow. So last night I had a wing going on. It was a very small wing, and I was going to do that, but then I just decided to reach for this eyeliner from NYX, and I'm just going to apply this to my lash line and blend it out using a eyeshadow brush. I had a little bit of trouble blending this eyeliner out. It is a new one. So to fix it, I took a dark brown eyeshadow. This is from the Kat Von D palette, of course. And I'm just applying this to my lash line just to diffuse that color a little bit. I might as well add this black shade too, just for kicks and giggles. So the result is a pretty diffused line, and I'm just bringing this out sort of halfway up to further define my eye. Now the challenge is doing the same thing on the other side without messing up. we're going to be going in with the Lorac Unzipped palette. This is the Unzipped Gold, and it has so many beautiful colors in it. I mean, seriously, like, this is me in a palette. I'm just going to be using a mixture of this color and this color right here for a highlight color. I'm just going to be using the same pencil brush I was using earlier. Next, I'm going to be going in with the Elizabeth Mott It's So Big mascara. This is a mascara I bought recently, and I've just been trying it out, and so far I really like it. I'm taking this leftover color from my flat brush, and I'm just applying this to my lower lash line to just define the look further. For lashes, I'm using the Ardell Demi Wispies. These are very natural looking, and I like them because I can wear them and people think that those are my natural lashes, but they just look amazing. So yeah, we're just going to be wearing these Demi Wispies. My attempt at putting on false lashes has proved successful on this eye, but will prove as successful on the second eye as well. We shall see. We shall see. Okay, don't judge me, by the way, if my lashes are not perfectly applied. I'm just learning. So the only reason I put on false lashes is because I tried these Demi Wispies on, and I'm like, I need them in my life. I need to put them on. And you want to wear them every single day. I feel like if I wear false lashes every single day, I'll have so much more practice. So that'll probably be a thing for me. So I'm done with my lashes now. Thank God I survived that. So now we're just going to be going in with the Zebras. Recently, what I've been doing is I've been taking my Morphe 350 palette, and I've been mixing these two shades together because they are pretty much the perfect brow color for me. So we're just going to be doing that real quickly, and then we're just going to move on. For cheeks, I'm going to be going in with my e.l.f. blush palette. This is such a gorgeous palette, and I'm just going to be using this one color right here since I kind of want like a brownish pinkish thing going on with my cheeks. For highlight, I'm using a little bit of Champagne Pop. This is such a gorgeous highlight. I cannot believe I haven't used it more often on camera, but it's so beautiful. I'm actually going to try and apply it with this fluffy brush right here. Usually I won't do this, but I kind of want more of a diffused highlight to make it look more like a glow other than like a specifically placed highlight. So I'm just going to try and see how this goes. I actually really like using this fluffy brush for my highlight. I feel like I should use this more often because it looks like I'm genuinely glowing other than just highlighting, if that makes sense. So for lips, I'm going in with the Revlon Ultra HD Matte Lip Color. This is in the shade Seduction, I believe. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. This is my first time using false lashes, so I'm really excited. Thank you so much for watching till the end, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.